Nuclear explosions are caused by weapons such as H-bombs or atom bombs. They are like ordinary explosions, only many times more powerful. They cause great heat and blast. They also make a cloud of deadly dust, which falls slowly to the ground. This is what is called fallout. So these are the two dangers. First, heat and blast, which is followed by fallout. The heat and blast is so severe that it can kill and can destroy buildings for up to 5 miles from the explosion. Fallout is dust that is sucked up from the ground by the explosion. It can be deadly dangerous. You can protect yourself and your family. If you have taken the advice we've been giving you recently, you will by now have chosen your fallout room and gathered your materials for an inner refuge. The time has now come to make everything ready for you and your family in case an air attack happens. This does not mean that war is bound to come, but there is a risk of this, and we must all be prepared for it. So, don't waste time. Start now. To help you, we will remind you once again about choosing a fallout room and an inner refuge. First, choosing a fallout room. That should be a room in your house which will give you the best possible protection from fallout. A room that is farthest from the outside walls and the roof, or one with the smallest amount of outside wall is safest. Whatever room you choose, remember that the further you can get away from radioactive dust in or around your home, the safer you will be. So in a house, the safest place is the ground floor or basement. In a block of flats, do not shelter in the top 2 floors if the block is 5 floors high or more. Go to the lower floors, ground floor or basement. The central corridors will give good protection. If you live in a bungalow or similar one-story home, it will not give you much protection. If you cannot make alternative arrangements, choose the safest place, which is a space farthest from the roof and outside walls. And now a reminder about your inner refuge. We have told you that your fallout room should be the safest place in your home. Even this is sometimes not safe enough, however, particularly for the first 2 days and nights after an attack, when the danger from radiation could be critical. So you need, inside your fallout room, an inner refuge. After an attack, fires will start in many places. The fire brigade may not be able to help everyone. So it might be up to us to tackle the fires in our own homes. Don't smoke. Put all the members of your family to work putting out fires in the house.
The most widespread danger from nuclear explosions is fallout. Fallout is dust that is sucked up from the ground by the explosion. Fallout can kill. Since it can be carried for great distances by the winds, it can eventually settle anywhere. So no place in the United Kingdom is safer than any other. The risk is as great in the countryside as in the towns. Nobody can tell where the safest place will be. So you are just as safe in your own home area as anywhere else. In fact, you are far better off at home because it is the place you know and where you are known. So, stay where you are. If you leave your home, your local authority may take it over for homeless families. And if you move, the authorities in the new place will not help you with food, accommodation, or other essentials. You are better off in your own home. stay there. Here is a reminder of what the air attack warning sounds like. This is the sound. When you hear the attack warning, you and your family must take cover at once. Do not stay out of doors. Keep the doors shut. Do not go outside the house until you are told it is safe. If you are caught in the open, lie down. Here is the all clear warning. When you hear this sound, you can leave your cover. But keep listening for further warnings. After a fallout warning, you have been advised to take cover in your inner refuge. The first 2 days will be the most dangerous period, because fallout will be at its worst. So it is in your best interest to stay in your inner refuge the whole of that time, however cramped or uncomfortable it may be. But if you must leave the refuge to go to the lavatory or to get more water or food, don't stay out a second longer than is necessary. In any case, don't go outside the fallout room at all. After 2 days, the danger from fallout will be less, but it may still kill you. So the longer you stay in your inner refuge, the better your chances are. Although it may be fairly safe for you to move about inside your fallout room, it certainly will not be safe for you to go outside the house until the radio tells you. So keep listening to your radio for advice. At first, you'll be told when you can go outside the house for a short time to get rid of lavatory waste and rubbish. Then, as the danger from fallout begins to pass away, you will be able to stay out for longer spells. There may still be a lot of fallout dust lying about, so be careful not to bring it back with you into the house. Keep a separate pair of boots or strong shoes for going out. Before coming in, take them off and wash or wipe them, soles as well. It is also a good idea to wear rubber gloves while you are outside. Try to keep the younger people indoors as much as possible. In fact, it will be far wiser for only people over 30 to work outside until things get better. After an attack is over and the all clear has been sounded, arrangements will be made as soon as possible to treat any people who are ill or injured. Listen to your radio. Details will be given about what to do, when to do it, and how. If anyone dies while you are kept in your fallout room, move the body to another room in the house. Label the body with name and address, and cover it as tightly as possible in polythene, paper, sheets, or blankets. Tie a second card to the covering. The radio will advise you what to do about taking the body away for burial. If, however, you have had a body in the house for more than 5 days, and if it is safe to go outside, then you should bury the body for the time being in a trench or cover it with earth, and mark the spot of the burial. Fallout can kill. Fallout can kill. Fallout can kill. Fallout can kill.